Thanks for joining me for another unboxing. This is an unboxing for the, it's really an air fryer. They're calling it an air fryer. It was called a hot air cooker when it first came out, and I guess different people are calling it different things now. They have it with the halogen on it, and they also have it with the infrared. I've used both. The infrared did not last 3 months. When that infrared light goes out, it will not heat. This one is by MegaChef. And the reason I'm doing this, I may have did one before, was the reason I'm doing this is because they have a ton of added, I guess you would call them, attachments on this. So I already opened it. I went through it and I was kind of amazed at what was in it. So that's why I'm doing this unboxing. The lid is what has your element. It's the major part of your hot air cooker or fryer. Let's show you what this looks like. It has the timer on and off. These go up to, the timer goes up to an hour. But it has the timer that you set, which allows you to walk away and don't worry about what's being cooked. And then they have the temperature setting here, which goes up to, this one goes up to 480. The other ones usually go up to 400. It also has a, they call it, on this one they're calling it a thaw, which I hadn't seen that before. They usually call it the wash cycle. So with these, to wash them, you put a small amount of water up to the fill line and a very small amount of detergent in there and turn it on to that setting. It will, usually you give it about 15 minutes. What happens is it heats it up just enough, sort of like with a microwave, cleaning a microwave. It'll heat up the inside and loosen anything that's in there. So then when you get ready to wash it, it will come right out. So here it is, the heating element on this side. And it's enclosed in this. This will get extremely hot. The whole thing will get extremely hot, except this lid part will not get hot, and the thing that it's seated in will not get hot either. So this gets really hot, and this has your cord on it, nice heavy duty cord with the grounding plug on it. This is your main part. When this goes out, you're done. All right, let's move on to the next part. Let me get this here. Now when you come into this, this is your, the body of it. This is where everything happens. You can cook anything imaginable in here except soup. You can't cook soup in here, but you can cook the elements for the soup. You can also bake in this. You can put a small turkey or a hen or a whole chicken. All can be cooked in here. So this, it will fit, if it'll fit inside this glass, and it is glass. It is thick glass too. It's the bottom. The bottom has a few ridges on it. However, it's seated in this thing off of the surface. Sit that to the side because I want to show you what else is in here. It's this ring. This is the extender ring. And it sits on top of that glass piece. And then you have the bottom, which has handles on it. Two handles on either side. Now this is a little flimsier than what I'm used to. It's attached to this metal base. And most of them don't have a metal base like this. One I've had a seat on it, a metal base on it, where that glass piece seats in here. But that's where the glass piece will seat. So I guess as long as these screws are firmly attached and in place, it'll hold the glass piece. It's just a little flimsier than what I'm used to. But it sits on here like this, so you see the. Move this box over us a little bit more area to play in, so to speak. And then this ring sits on top of here. Trying to see which way. There's a thing on here that icon that tells you it is hot, which it does get hot. Trying to see, this seats down inside, so there's a lip inside the glass base. Put the seat inside here. And then the lid seats right on there. So this lid goes up and down. The handle goes up and down. There's these have a little button on them. The older ones didn't have a button on them. So you can press that button down and it seats in place. But once it goes in place, there's another button here that causes it to come on. And then when you want to get your items out, you just lift this up. Lift it straight up and off. And then you have where you can sit your lid at. So let's get everything out the way and we'll show you where you sit your lid at. Because the earlier ones didn't come with a piece that you set the lid on. These do. We're going to maneuver this over because I want to show you all of these things that they give you in this one that they didn't give in the other ones. So it has this weird shape and it goes bent edge up. So with the bent edge seated, sitting upward. And that will keep it up. So that's how you'll seat that one. So it'll actually be seated like this. On there, I hate that it's on that glass. But that's how they want you to seat that. And it'll sit up off the surface. If you don't feel great with that, what I generally do is, I guess the metal ring, the metal rim around the lid also helps support it down here on this bottom end. If you're not happy with that or comfortable with it, then you can put it on the stovetop. I often sit this lid when it's hot on the stovetop. I use this near the plug. Well, the cord is not that long, but it's long enough for me to use it near one of the plugs on the stove is. I was really impressed by the number of items they give you. Although these items are not as sturdy as the items were when they first came out with them, and I'm assuming different manufacturer. But you have this. This is sort of like your tongs. It's a little flimsy here. I don't know how well this is going to hold up. It comes with two racks. A lower rack that sits in the bottom. And I've used this rack in both positions. This is a normal position with these four legs here on the bottom. They have four legs on the bottom. That's a normal position. But I've also used it, I flipped it up like that. So this goes on the bottom. And then this rack goes on the top. So you can cook two layers at a time. This rack, the layer is not that, the feet on there are not that long. On the other ones, they were taller than this. But this will work. And when you're cleaning this, you want to put both of these, or either or whichever one you have, you want to flip them upside down so that they fit in the water when you're cleaning it. You turn it on to clean it. You get this little, it says instruction booklet. It talks about the dangers, malfunctioning, how to bake, how to roast, how to cook. It gives you this little small cooking guide on the back that talks about pizza, fish, lobster, roast, and chicken. And then it has your temperature zones. It has a little troubleshooting area. Generally, if it doesn't come on, that handle is not pushed down all the way. If the handle is pushed down all the way, you want to check your plug, because some plugs will trip. And then you just make sure that's pushed on or plugged all the way in. And then you have these other items, which nice. The other ones were taller, or the depth of them were taller, but that's okay because the last one I got didn't have this in there. Some of the first ones had this basket in there, which is great for your different foods that you put in and say you want to fry some. The main thing with this, cooking with this, is that the air has to circulate around the entire thing and it will cook faster. It doesn't have to, but it cooks faster if the air circulates completely around it. Now this is your baking and steamer tray. So you know you steam stuff, it's got the holes in it. And then you have this baking tray. And this one is thicker than the ones I'm used to. The other ones were thicker. The depth of them was higher, but they were not this thick. And they have that on there. Why? I have no idea. They put that plastic, protective plastic on that one, but not the rest of the stuff. However, you get, I'm telling you, you get the steamer in here, you get the basket in here, you get that baking tray in here, you get your shelving, whether, you know, your racks, two different racks, and you get this little gripper slash tongs that go in it, plus that thing to put your lid on. So I've only purchased one other one that comes with that lid stand. So when you're going to clean this, you want to put about an inch of water in the bottom, no more than an inch of water in the bottom, and just a few drops of detergent. Turn it on turn the timer on, or this on to, that's the temperature gauge, on to thaw, clean, or wash. That's where you want to put it at, and give it about 15 minutes. But everything else fits in there. You put the lid on there and turn it on. It'll ding. You don't have to watch it. You'll hear it ding. And once it does, you're good to go. They also have on top of here the food, how many minutes and what the temperature is. All right. Thanks for joining me. Until next time.